What is it?
We got something cooking you might be interested in.
Am I gonna like the sound of this?
Been cooking since Horseshoe, but you went and kicked up all that commotion in Valentine. Now, we was preparing to rob the bank there until you got involved in all that nonsense, and I don't know, I just feel like it's unfinished business.
That wasn't my fault. It was just one of them things.
How come every time I get in trouble, I'm called a fool and an idiot? But when you get in trouble, oh, it's just one of them things.
It's a good point, Arthur.
A very good point.
All right, well, what do y'all want me to do?
Hit the goddamn bank with us.
You really think it's worth going back there?
Four of us can hit the bank easy, but I ain't gonna lie to you. There will be law if we linger.
And if we're serious?
No, just local boys being rounded up and pressed into action.
Meaning?
If we go in quick and quiet, we can hit it just fine. If there's four of us, I mean.
Y'all think it's worth the risk?
It's a bank, Arthur.
So? Is the take good?
According to the fella I met, yes. It's the end of the stock sales. Plenty of money and plenty of people milling about.
All right, I suppose it's worth taking a look at least.
We should wait until the morning. In any case, I need to change out of these rags if I'm gonna be performing.
Okay. So, Bill, this better be worth it.
Oh, it is. We put a lot of research into this one.
I hope so. All right. Let's go.
Mr. Morgan.
Herr Strauss?
That man. The debtor, Thomas Downs, apparently he's dead.
Dead? Huh. Well, he didn't seem very well.
His wife. I believe he has a wife and child. She will assume the debt, of course.
Of course.
When you can, head up there and collect. We lent them a lot of money.
Okay.
Gentlemen, let's go rob ourselves a bank.
What's the plan, then?
Oh, well, we're gonna send Karen on in ahead as a distraction. Then we're just gonna rush on in afterwards. Just a small bank in a little town. Nothing that big in way of security. We just need to bring you along as a insurance policy.
Yeah, that sounds about right.
Okay, let's move out.
So, tell me again about this big can't-go-wrong plan of yours.
Oh, it can go wrong. Anything can, once the shooting starts.
Well, that's reassuring.
Like I said, we'll see how it looks. If we can get in all right, we'll send Miss Jones ahead to the bank. They won't recognize her.
I'll show you boys how it's done.
What are you thinking this time?
I don't know. Fellers always like the lost little girl, but nobody plays a drunken harlot quite like me. It should work.
Once he's got them distracted, we'll move in.
When I was scouting the place the other day, there was only a couple of guards.
We deal with them and any customers who are feeling brave. And you always fancy yourself as the vault man, right, Arthur?
Now I see why you brought me.
Hey, I'm more than willing.
Nah, best I do it.
Oh, and did Dutch tell you I've also been cooking up some deals with them gray boys?
What? No. What kind of deals?
See, you don't realize, Morgan. I'm out there putting in the work same as you. I've been drinking with them a couple times now. Seems they're looking for some extra security.
Yeah, I'm sure they are.
Could be something in it for us.
Well, just be smart about it. We got a lot of irons in that fire right now.
Yes, I know, Morgan.
Can't believe you got me going back to Valentine.
Don't tell me it ain't hurt you leaving that bank behind.
Not really.
Work a town and not hit the bank? That's downright pathetic.
I guess we went a bit beyond working it. We shot the place to hell.
You did, Morgan. Not me. I played it cool up there. Couple of punch-ups, dealt with some old Driscolls.
Oh, is that right?
Like I said, you mess up,
It's just one of them things.
I mess up. I'm the prize idiot.
Well, Bill, I don't know what to tell you.
Surprised you ain't already ripped me about that dynamite again. One mistake, and I'll never live it down.
What do you need? A pat on the back? A medal?
Just know, I got the lead on this one.
We'll see about that once things get going. So, thinking this through, you rob Cornwall's train, we shoot a heap of his men in Valentine, we rob his stagecoach.
This is just dawning on you now?
And now, we're going back to the one place he knew where to find us.
That's the genius of it. Folk never look at what's right under their nose.
I ain't sure that's always true.
What's happened to you? You're getting real nervy in your old age.
The last few weeks happened.
Forget about Cornwall. He can't have many men left at this point. Got a bit hairy in that barn, but we all walked away fine from that.
Didn't walk away with much.
If four of us could deal with them in Valentine, and four of us could deal with them after the coach robbery, I ain't too worried.
If you say so. So, how are you feeling about this, Lenny?
Well, at first I thought it was a bad idea. But then I figured, they all are if you think about them long enough.
Certainly have been recently.
I mean, why the hell not? Roll with it. I just told them we needed you along.
I appreciate the confidence, kid.
And if we didn't rob this bank, we really would be slipping.
Thoughts like that, and you're one of us, no doubt.
Sure hope so.
All right. Guess we're doing this, then. You did well with that gang at Shady Bell.
Yeah, thanks. And I heard the rest of them have moved on from there now, so we must have sent enough of a message.
I reckon so.
I ain't lose much sleep over them fellas.
Me neither.
They'd have loved nothing more than to strang me up.
That weren't gonna happen. That'll have to wait. We're here. Let's take it nice and easy.
Howdy, dude.
You this bored, you want to make an enemy?
Good morning.
Hello.
Leave the horses here off the main drive.
All right, gentlemen, here we are.
Okay, get ready. Karen, go to work.
Of course. All right, keep it cool and follow me, fellas.
So, we never decided. Is it lost little girl you want, or the drunken harlot? So which one?
I think I'd like to see the little girl lost.
So even you long to save the fallen women, eh, Arthur?
You break my heart. You really do.
Well, you're ready, get going.
Good luck, gentlemen.
We got this. Okay, we're going.
No, hold on. Wait till she's got him real dead.
Child, and it's... I don't want to go back to the workhouse.
Get your goddamn hands up! Go. This is a goddamn robbery!
Nobody move! No word up! Nobody move! Don't make us hurt you! Here, unlock the door.
Okay, the door's unlocked.
Oh, you think we're here? Come on. Open the goddamn vault! Open it!
How's it going in there?
Too slowly! You better get that door open right now.
I'm nearly there.
Too goddamn slow! Bitch, hurry up! Come on!
Okay.
Come on. I'm in! Someone come make sure the suit behaves himself in here.
Come here. Open the lockboxes now!
The manager does that.
God damn it! Now what?
Guess I'll crack them or blow them up. Keep an eye out. I'll be as quick as I can. Yeah, I think I should be able to crack these.
All right, but you better be quick. You shut the hell up and stay still!
Hey, keep still. If I see that leg move again, you get a bullet in it.
How much time do you think we got?
I don't know. Not much. This is taking too long.
Come on, come on!
I hear people out there.
Me too. Boys, you need to move this along!
How are you getting on? I'm
going as fast as I can. This is slower, but it's quieter.
Okay.
Hey, watch him there.
Don't worry. I see him.
Please, let me go. I won't say nothing. I swear.
Shut the hell up and stay where you are.
How's it looking there?
Good.
Told you.
Don't count your chickens just yet.
Bill, how's it going in there?
We're getting there. A few more minutes.
I'll go check the front.
That's another one cleared. This is looking good.
How much longer?
Nearly there.
Okay, you reckon that's enough now?
Maybe. It's never enough.
Well, I am ready to get the hell out of here whenever you are.
Last one.
Good. We gotta move.
Come on, I'll lead the way.
Let's go. Everybody, stay calm. All of you count to 100 and keep your mouth shut. You understand me? I think we lost him.
Thank you, gentlemen. That was...
stupid and dangerous. Thank you, Bill.
We're alive and we're paid.
Yeah.
I don't see the problem.
And that is the problem. Still,
this is
a very good take. Dutch will be happy, even if it did come with a heap of trouble.
It was fun.
Well, maybe you're right. Now, go on, get out of here. I have some other business to attend to. Don't head directly back to camp, and make sure you ain't followed! Okay. This is Downs. You can always rely on you, boy.
You okay, boy?
To see you again. Good on you. Get a fresh start. Folks in New Hanover will be glad to hear it.
Thanks.
My husband's not cold in the ground, and you've come back here. Archie, I nearly paid off what was owed.
Your husband knew the rules when he took that money. Now, I'm real sorry about the way things turned out, but he had a choice. Ain't my fault about the way the world is.
He didn't have a choice. He was good, and he did good. There wasn't no choice in that. And you've as good as killed him yourself, and don't kid yourself. You had a choice.
You speak as if killing was something I cared about.
You ever wonder about eternity? You should.
I hope it's hot and terrible, Mrs. Downs. Otherwise, I'll feel I've been sold a false bill of goods. Now, please, give me that money. Either you got a lazy eye or lack of respect. Which is it, boy?
I ain't got no lazy eye. No respect for the likes of you.
Well, maybe when your mother's finished mourning your father, I'll keep her in black, on your behalf. You think on that, boy?
Well, maybe you shall, sir. And maybe other events will transpire.
You best stick to them books, because mark my words on this. Vengeance is an idiot's game. Ah, Mrs. Downs, thank you for your punctuality. It's next to godliness, isn't it?
That's cleanliness.
I'll have to take your word on that. Good day.
Last night, huh?
Don't want to sit on those rifles too long.
They remembered to rob the goddamn bank in Valentine. Rest of us. Rest of us. Are slipping. Pride. Never forget the pride in our work. You four, I salute you.
You okay, Tilly? Karen?
Taking that lawman outfit a bit serious, are you?
Arthur.
You going fishing?
Yes.
Or running off to Colm O'Driscoll?
Of course not.
I was joking.
That's very funny. Yes, very funny. I saved your life, and now you torture me. Ho, ho.
Shut up.
Do you want to go fishing with me? I found an interesting spot. We'll do well.
I'm not a great fisherman.
But I am. I'll teach you something. We come?
Sure.
All right, then. Grab your horse and let's go.
Son of a bitch!
Okay, follow me. I know a great little fishing spot along the beach. Who'd have thought it? Wasn't that long ago I was tied to the back of your horse while begging for mercy. Now we're all fishing together.
How do you know I ain't just looking for a good place to drown you?
Because I saved your life, Arthur.
You keep saying that. But I save your life every day I don't kill you. So we are more than even on that front.
Come on, you don't mean that.
You better believe I mean it. Now, where's this spot?
Not much further.
You okay, boy?
This is the place. Some beautiful smallmouth here.
Bass?
Sure. This strip of shore looks perfect. Pick a spot. Hey. Be careful. I don't want to hook you, Arthur. Seeing lots of bluegill and bass over here. Bait with worms or crickets if you got them. Otherwise, maybe some bread or cheese.
You getting many bites there, O'Driscoll?
I ain't an O'Driscoll. I told you fellas 100 times. I'd only been with them a couple of months. I was just a runner, helping out with the horses mainly. Bottom rung of the ladder.
And to think that was the high point of your career.
Comb goes through men like cigars. They ain't like you folks. You barely knew my name. I'm more Kieran Vanderlyn than Kieran O'Driscoll at this point. Honest to God. Mostly I'm Kieran Duffy.
I hate to break it to you, but I ain't sure Kieran Vanderlyn is gonna stick.
There you go. Not too fast. You could break the line. Nice. Good catch, Arthur. Now see if you can hook another. So, you think Dutch trusts me now?
That's a good one.
What?
Not in the slightest, my friend.
I can't win. I promised loyalty, he says, but you wasn't loyal to Combe. If I say I ain't got no allegiance to nobody, he says, how do I know you won't turn on us then?
I don't know what you want to hear. I'm trying hard to feel sorry for you, but somehow I just can't manage to.
What in the world? Arthur, are you seeing this? The feather's naked as a jaybird.
Is that why you like this spot?
My lord.
Hey, watch the
there's
line.
There's someone who needs to go to confession.
I nearly gulped down a minnow. Sorry, fellas. Didn't see you there. Why don't you take a break? Come on in. The water's wonderful. You here for some fishing?
We hope to. You haven't scared them all away, have you?
Oh, just so you fellas know, there's some real big ones over that way, like this. Well, I better keep the blood pumping. Hope you gents catch something.
Yeah? Maybe we'll take a look. Thanks.
I know where that is. Come on, let's go.
Hey, wait up! Come on, pal.
I think this is the place that naked feller was talking about. Did you see that amazing bluegill?
Sure. That got you real excited, huh?
Come on, Arthur. Let's walk down to the beach.
I hope we land this monster.
Uh-huh.
It ain't easy to catch. Fish like that with bread and cheese, but you never know. We might get lucky.
Guess we'll see.
Cast one in then, Arthur.
So who taught you how to fish?
My pappy, mostly. I lost my mammy and pappy when I was young to cholera.
Your mammy?
Like I said, I was real young. After that, I was on my own pretty much, but I knew horses and fishing.
Well, just think now, you'll never be alone again.
Did you hook him, the big one?
I don't know. Don't feel like much of a fighter.
Not bad, but it ain't the one we saw jump out of the water.
See? Look at this. Life ain't so bad. At least you ain't tied to a tree.
I'm still a prisoner, Arthur. I can't step outside camp by myself for a second without being terrified of one of Combs' boys gonna come pick me up. When I'm in camp, I got Bill and Sadie whispering in my ear all the time how they're gonna kill me in my sleep. It's like living in a nightmare.
Christ. If I'd known you were gonna moan this much, I'd have never have said yes to this.
You got it. That has got to be the one, right?
Nah, it don't feel very big to me.
No, that's not it. I don't think we have much chance. We need better bait. You might want to see if the stores around here sell anything better. I think I'm gonna head back to camp, Arthur, if that's okay.
Sure. Go on, I'll see you later. Okay, feller.
Yeah. Whoa.
Yeah. Nicely done, boy.
What do you want, boy?
This here the Gray Plantation?
Yep. Callagher Hall. And that's as close as you...
Sheriff's orders. You wanted me to have a word with some folk on the property. I'm recently deputized, you see.
Deputized? And I suppose Lee was drunk when he did it? Look, you can come in, but you ain't talking with me.
Obliged.
Coming in or what?
Hey, I was hoping you'd talk a moment. I'm a student of the history of the region, and,
I ain't the one to speak to. Try Master Bo. Think he's down there by the wood store. Boy's got all the time in the world.
Come on now, boy. You're a good boy. Huh. I'll see you at the sheriff's office.
Excuse me, friend.
We friends?
Not yet, but he is hoping.
I guess.
We don't get a lot of traveling men here, and suddenly there's a whole phalanx of mysterious but strangely helpful Yankees about the place.
Is there?
What are you doing here?
I was just looking for work.
Well, looking for something. Don't worry, your secret's safe with me.
What secret?
I got a secret of my own.
Are you secretly normal?
Excuse me?
Never mind.
The thing is, I don't care if you kill the whole lot of us and the Braithwaites.
I don't want to kill anyone.
I love her, you know.
Love who?
Penelope. But it's impossible.
Well, love tends to be complicated.
She's a Braithwaite. I'm Bo Gray, son of Tavish Gray, nephew of Lee Gray, the sheriff, grandson of old Murdo Gray. We Greys have been loyal to the state and murderous to the Braithwaites for so long now, no one can even quite explain why. Beyond blind loyalty and stupidity, I'm supposed to be loyal to some nonsense while she's amazing. She's like a woman from the future. She's like tomorrow, if tomorrow turns out fine.
Well, I'm sorry for your predicament.
Would you help?
I don't want to get involved. Gang feuds. Seems unseemly.
I'll pay. I've got money. We Greys, we've always got money. No brains, mind, but money.
Well, in that case...
I know she loves to sit out in the gazebo on the edge of the Braithwaite property. Take her this letter and this bracelet, please.
Oh, look out for their guards. They're worse with strangers than ours are. So long. And good luck. I should really appreciate you taking those to her.
Thinking, when this is done, you can fill me in on the goings-on around here.
Oh, yes, sir. Assuredly.
All right, then. It's just, I'm the curious kind. Okay there. Are you Penelope Braithwaite?
Why, yes, I am.
I've got a letter for you.
Oh.
And a gift.
A letter and a gift. Well, we don't even know each other.
Well, it's not from me. It's from,
From Bo. Oh, he is so...
strange?
Yes, he's a little strange, but also so human. The rest of our families are stuck in the Dark Ages or, well, I don't know, cave people, perhaps. Bo's different. But if they find out, they'll kill him and send me to live someplace awful like Ohio. Have you ever been to Ohio, sir?
No.
Well, neither have I, but my uncle has a factory there. He was sort of the black sheep on account of having left. But now they tolerate him because he's a vicious snob. Families are... there's something else. You got a family, sir?
No, not really.
Well, they tolerate him because of the money. But me, with my ideas above my station, they can't stand.
That sounds pretty complicated. I don't know quite what to say.
Well, nothing to say except I hope they all rot. I don't. Well, maybe a bit. But here, if you see Bo again, will you give this to him?
Sure. Thank you. You know me, I'm on official business for the family.
All right, come on.
You got my money?
Sure. Did she give anything? For me?
Yes.
Might I have it?
Sure. But it'll cost you. I can't be bothered. Here, take it. Oh,
thank you, Arthur. Thank you. My God. What a woman. She's... This'll get her killed, for sure.
What?
Women's suffrage. Around here, they don't even like men voting. They'd bring back the monarchy, given half the chance. Progress is a dirty word in these parts. Unlike incest.
Excuse me?
I don't want to marry my cousin Matilda. I want to marry Penelope. But they're gonna... They'll kill her at one of those rallies they're holding. They've done it before. Mister, you gotta help.
No, I'm afraid I don't want no part of it.
I'll pay. My family, we've still got some money.
Fine. Just No more running around with letters.
Thank you. Come on. We better get going.
Get there in time, my true love may be shot.
If she wants to rally, you gotta let her rally.
Well, good as the cause is, I can't let her become a martyr to it. I want to marry a flesh and blood woman, not a statue in her honor.
I'm sure they know what they're doing.
There they are.
Ladies.
Bo, what are you doing here?
I cannot
let you go through with this. You'll be killed!
I'm prepared to die for the cause, Bo. You know that.
Do something, please!
What? Fight this mob?
We must begin.
They need me alive.
This is no laughing matter, sir. They need protecting from certain elements. Mostly my family. Penelope, I beg you.
I'll tell you what. Your friend here can drive the wagon for us. It'll allow us to shout all the louder.
Hooray!
Sure.
Miss Calhoun.
Oh, so
Miss Calhoun.
Yes.
My friend here says he can drive the wagon.
Well, Olive Calhoun. Normally I like to drive myself, but today I feel like a man joining us sends the right message.
Well, I ain't never been in a protest march before, madam.
Well, just treat us like the sheep and the folks attacking us like the wolves, and I'm sure you feel right at home. Shall we go? All right, ladies. We know our song is a good one, and we know our cause is a pure one.
Yes, ma'am.
Let liberty reign!
We're mothers, wives, housekeepers, and daughters. We cook the food and we fetch the
Now. Take us down Main Street, right through town to the steps of the Bank of Roads, Mr.
What was your name?
Arthur Morgan.
Very good, Mr. Morgan. Not too quick and not too slow. We need them to hear our voice.
Well, they'll hear it all right.
Very good, very good. Mr. Morgan, are you an old friend of the movement?
I'm just a driver, Mrs. Calhoun. Maybe a shotgun messenger if it comes to it. I hope it won't.
Well, our message will be delivered peaceably, Mr. Morgan. You can keep your shotgun to yourself. Stay on Main Street. It's a left up here, Mr. Morgan. Look at these people. It's about to get exciting. I can feel it.
I believe you might be right.
Good day, Sheriff. I trust you'll make sure it's a peaceful assembly.
Easy there.
Oh, don't give it a rest, you sorry fool. Mr. Morgan, I give you the male of the species.
Yeah, it's a pretty dumb specimen, I grant.
A little further, please. Stop just past the bank.
This spot is fine, sir.
Ladies, get down!
Come on!
Go home!
Shut your mouth!
What are you doing?
The hell is going on? Welcome here!
Oh, my God. Stop
shitting and causing all this trouble.
You don't even know what you're
saying.
And gentlemen,
yes.
This is a great day for all of us.
Yay.
For today is the day we begin to live as equals.
Equals!
Yes, equal, sir. Fair and equal.
This is unnatural. This is nonsense.
Yes. Fair, equal, and free, just as the founding fathers intended.
Yes. Founding fathers, not founding mothers, you silly old goat.
Philosophy dependent on biology.
What the hell are you doing here, boy?
Keep your voice down. I'm trying to listen to the speech.
Hello, darling cousin.
Don't you ever speak to me like that.
Shh.
What are you doing here?
Listening, I suppose.
Go help Bo. His cousin is a moron. And stop them from ruining the speech.
You need to learn yourself some manners, cousin.
Haven't you got anything better to do?
Oh, you always was.
Bo, weren't we just leaving?
Who the hell is this?
Follow me, Ronnie.
Oh, what? You'll hit me?
Come on.
Sir, can you not see how idiotic you are?
Come on, Bo. Let's go. Quick now.
We are all American.
We gotta go before they think twice. Oh, Lord. Follow me. I know a place. It's an old battlefield no one goes to.
Of equality, a land of progress. Look at the beautiful land we have built.
But you don't want to go back and hear the speech?
Or we all wither together. Yes, progress is our nation's only hope for salvation.
No one's relying on
it. We stay stuck in the past.
This is awful.
Nobody died. Ain't that awful?
My cousins are vindictive bastards. My brothers are vindictive bastards. My cousins are worse.
They started it.
I know, but
you should leave.
I will, as soon as I have enough money. When my family, we have money, but I don't.
Is your family very rich?
Yes, well, I believe so, but they keep me out of the discussions. I have more of a artistic temperament, so.
Oh, is that what they call it?
Yes. Oh, you made a joke.
Mm.
I really love her. I do.
Well, stick around. Maybe you can die for her as well.
I thought you were trying to make me feel better.
Look, I gotta go.
Me too. Oh, damn! I'm gonna be late. My uncle is quite as bad as you would imagine. Here, your payment. Thank you. Excuse me.
Catch your breath, boy.
Morning, Arthur.
Yeah, you all right there, boy?
Yeah,
I'll stay there, boy. There you go, boy.
Bring me something soon if you can, Arthur.
All right, Pearson.
Thank you, Arthur.
Hey, Arthur.
What's going on?
Jose and John are looking for you. They went out to the moonshine stash, said you knew where that was. They was planning a visit to the Braithwaite place, but John needs to do something for Dutch now, so Hosea wants you to join him instead. Seems to be a lot going on.
You're telling me. Okay, thank you.
Good morning, Arthur.
Don't feel right seeing you wearing that badge.
Morning. That ambition will see you far.
Thanks, Arthur.
Just keep a calm head on your shoulders.
Sure.
Hey, Arthur.
What are you doing?
Selling it back to where it came from.
Why?
I ain't got a market for it. They made it. They must have someone to sell it to. Stuff look kind of lonely out here. I think we'll cut ourselves a deal.
I get you.
You and Dutch was just doing your duty when you requisitioned it. Now I'm doing mine.
All right. I should get going now. I'll leave you fellas to it. Good luck.
Thank you, John. We'll see you later. Dutch asked him to look into something to do with the Braithwaite horses, I think.
Sure, okay.
Okay, let's head out to the Braithwaite's place. You know the way?
Yeah, I've been there. So what exactly are we doing? This is the moonshine we took after blowing up the Braithwaite still, right?
I think the good citizens taking the trouble to return their stolen goods deserve some reward, don't you? And it's time we made a formal introduction, like Dutch told us. Look, these are two big old plantation houses. All I keep hearing is they hate each other so much they can't see past it.
I know. I've seen it. There's a gray boy and a Braithwaite girl carrying on a secret affair. I've been, well, helping them.
The mind boggles. You think they're of use?
Not sure. They don't seem too involved in the rest of it, but maybe.
Well, I'm sure there's money in this for us somewhere if we can get in the middle of it.
Thank you.
are.
Modest little homestead, isn't it?
Hello, gentlemen. How are you?
What's that in the back there?
Moonshine, my fine fellow. May I have a word with the man of the house?
The man of the house is a lady. Mrs. Catherine Braithwaite.
May I speak with her? I want to discuss a business opportunity. I mean no harm. No harm at all. You may happily shoot me if I do.
Okay. She's at the house. We'll be watching you.
You heard the man. Driver, proceed, please. Something out in the hills. Thought maybe you was in the market for it.
For what?
Some liquor.
I ain't in the market for what's already mine.
The way we see it, it's ours. Well, with us possessing it, and I checked all over. For the life of me, I couldn't see your name on it. Whoa. Relax. I ain't here to rob you. No, it seems that's easy enough. Want to do a deal? What do you sell that stuff for?
$1 a bottle.
Give us 50 cents.
It's already ours.
Well, look on it as a reward for finding the property. Alternative is we go sell it someplace else.
The alternative is you get shot.
Now, who wants to get shot over a bottle or two of liquor?
Pay the man.
Pleasure doing business with you. And listen, we didn't take it, at least not without orders from...
Oh, I know exactly who gave you your orders. Old Sheriff Gray. You know what? I don't want it. In fact, sir, now you can do me a favor. There's an extra $10 if you do. Drive the stuff into Rhodes, head over to the tavern run by Mr. Gray, and give the stuff out for free.
Mama!
Hush now. I believe they call that a promotional expense.
As you wish, madam.
You boys come back sometime and tell me how you made out. Maybe we'll play a little cribbage.
All right. Next stop, the Rhodes Saloon.
Here we go.
So I finally sold those Cornwall bonds. Got close to 1,000 for them. I wanted more, but not bad considering how hot they were. Especially after that bloodbath in Valentine.
No, not bad at all.
Apparently, Cornwall's been pumping a lot of cash into the Pinkertons. Wants to keep their full effort on going after gangs. Gangs like us.
Yeah, that don't surprise me.
All right. This could get ugly. You and Dutch already have that thing going on in town with... the sheriff.
Yeah, Mr. Gray.
That's it. Now we're inserting ourselves in his blood feud. We'll need something.
I ain't playing dress up. You know how I feel about that.
Of course you're not. You're a clown's idiot brother.
Hosea, please.
I'm the clown. You're the idiot. Just look sad and keep quiet. Even you can do that, Arthur.
Oh, I have to.
Put this hat on. Smoke this pipe. Bring your lip forward just a bit. Squint. Oh, perfect.
What about you?
Oh, shh. You can't speak. You're turned idiot. Right? Broke poor Mammy's heart. There, Fenton. Don't get mad now.
Thank you.
Okay, Fenton, stay calm now. For Mama, she loved you so. Just a shame you had to strangle her in a rage, right? Grab two cases of that stuff and follow me. Quite the town you have here. We just rode in from up north.
Hey.
Hello. Hello, I'm Melvin. This is my brother Fenton. Don't mind him. Don't madden him. He's turned idiot. Killed our mother, but it weren't his fault. How'd you boys like a couple of bucks? I bet you would. One for each of you. We're in the new trade of advertising, which is an American art form about ensuring people buy the correct things.
I don't know.
One more dollar. Says give us half an hour. What harm can we do in half an hour? Go along now. Enjoy the money. Come along, Fenton. Just hand out the liquor. Gentlemen! Gentlemen! My name is Melvin. That's my brother Fenton. He's a bit funny, but boy, can he pour drinks fast. For the next 30 minutes, the drinks in this here bar, in this here town, are entirely free. Yeah. The only rule is that you gotta drink them. So hurry up, put old Fenton to work. Don't get him mad, though. His mama made him mad, and we buried her. Poor thing. Ah. Now, come up to the bar, everybody. Come on, fellas, it's your lucky day.
I'll have one, Fenton.
A gift. Bounty. It's a sin to look a gift horse, Fenton. When I see a gift horse, I
don't
have
my eyes. Huh? That's some strong stuff.
Get yourself.
Just keep them coming.
Drink up. Don't be shy, boys. Don't be shy. It's the land of opportunity. Now it's your opportunity.
Mr. Gray won't be happy about this.
Fenton, open another bottle. Idiot's
where's mine, then?
Come on. We got work to do, my boys. Let's go. Providence.
You're a fine man, Fenton. A fine man. Don't listen to your brother.
Come along.
Over here, Fenton.
Fenton. Inebriate these fine gentlemen. That's it.
This way, will ya?
Keep drinking. There's plenty more where that came from, and it's all free. And serve these poor gentlemen, Fenton.
Whoa, wife is gonna kill me. I only went out for milk.
What have you got against free drinks, boys? Fenton, snap out of it. I'm sorry, gentlemen. He's not normally this slow.
Just keep him coming.
Drink up!
Lemoyne Raiders.
Good evening, gentlemen. Quiet libation?
You.
Me?
You're the bastard who stole the liquor we was gonna buy.
Gentlemen, we're in advertising. Come on in and have a drink.
That's our goddamn liquor.
An honest mistake.
Boys, get him!
Damn it!
this way.
That's how it goes, you damn bastards.
Let's go. Out of here.
Ain't gonna let this go, are they?
Over there! They got out the back!
Got more coming after us.
I see them.
Well, shoot them then!
You think we wouldn't find you?
To your right! Behind us, Arthur! Coming out of the alley! Right ahead of you!
We run on the girl!
I'm getting us out of here.
Ain't gonna let this go, are they?
Over there! They got out the back!
Got more coming after us.
Ah! I see them.
Well, shoot them then. Behind us, Arthur, coming out of the alley.
You think we won't find you?
Shit, that hit the liquor.
We're gonna show you that they're more than just.
How many are there? They really aren't happy about this.
We run the liquor around here. Stay the hell out of our business.
There's more to your right.
I want both those sons of bitches dead.
Look out, folks.
Made it!
Behind you!
Too damn close!
Hold on! Think you can steal from us? You're dead, man!
That's how you want to do it?
Got me!
I'm getting us out of here.
Ain't gonna let this go, are they?
Over there! They got out the back!
Got more coming after us.
I see them.
Well, shoot them then.
You think we wouldn't find you?
Look out! It's more they don't want another gang on their patch.
Okay. Pull off the road here.
All right. We're good.
Yeah. Remind me never to take up a career in... What was it?
Advertising.
Yeah. You think that woman set us up?
No, I don't think so. Maybe. This place is odd.
I keep seeing those fellas.
Some local militia. Clearly not too happy to have some new competition. I'll go visit old Ma Braithwaite, see what's what.
Why?
We've been making money. The chest is filling up again, slowly but surely. Part of me thinks we just get ourselves good and lost. But we still need a lot more money before that can happen. So, for now, let me go give old Mrs. Braithwaite some of this moonshine as, well, let's call it a peace offering.
Sure.
That was fun, Fenton. We'll make an actor of you yet.
Yeah. I'll go speak to Dutch.
So, what do you think?
About what?
The fine folks around these parts.
Oh, real nice.
Exactly. On the one side, we have got the Gray family. Scots, degenerates, drunkards, the local law. You couldn't make this stuff up. Rich as Croesus. And on the other, their mortal enemies, the Braithwaites. Moonshiners, hypocritical, both rolling, we believe.
In gold.
And in the middle of it all, you got some inbred retelling of Romeo and Juliet.
Exactly.
So what you boys thinking?
We try to rob them both.
You sure?
Why not?
Because we got lawmen in three different states after us.
Last thing I want is to get us into trouble, but we need money. Now, we have the opportunity here to put ourselves in the middle of something ain't nobody gonna know we was here, because even without us, these fools are gonna kill each other anyway.
Okay, well, Hosea's gone back to see that Braithwaite woman.
Good. Hosea should definitely take the lead on this. I sent Sean over to Braithwaite Manor, too. Now, you can meet up with them, or join John and Javier at the Gray's place. Something to do with the Braithwaite's prize horses.
Well, how the hell did we get an inn at the Gray's place?
Sheriff Gray kindly put in a word with his father. It ain't that complicated. We gotta convince each family that we're on their side, and then we rob them both. Before they figure out it was us that done it, and not the other lot, we'll be long...